Thank you so much. So my presentation is on LAMP for Mycobacterium bovis and neglected diseases. So I'll start by talking a bit about Mycobacterium bovis as our target. Mycobacterium bovis is a member of Mycobacterium tuberculosis complex, and it is the primary pathogen of cattle causing bovine tuberculosis, which is known as BTB. BTB is a respiratory disease characterized by chronic debilitating state and formation of granulomatous nodules, as you can see from the pictures. The impact of bovine tuberculosis ranges into three categories. One, in livestock, it contributes to negative economic impact due to high production costs of sick animals, animal products contamination, and also trade barriers. Again, in wildlife, a spillover to wildlife, it threatens the endangered species and difficult to eradicate. And finally, in humans, when it's transmitted to humans, it's called zoonotic TB, and it's also a problem, as you'll see later on. Globally, bovine tuberculosis in cattle is distributed globally, and most of the burden is in developing countries. And for zoonotic TB, it's also globally distributed, with most cases in developing countries as well, and Africa bears the highest burden as of 2017. Diagnostically, bovine tuberculosis, we diagnose using tuberculin test. We can use culture, immunological tests, biochemical tests, and also postmortem and other molecular tests such as PCR and the rest. To control bovine TB in cattle, basically we do test and slaughter. So it's basically a tuberculin test and then slaughter the positive animals, and also cattle movement control. We do not vaccinate and also medicate, because medication could be a bit expensive. Zoonotic tuberculosis control in humans highly depend on the control of bovine tuberculosis in cattle, and also appropriate hygienic measures and treatment of the sick, as we can see from these pictures. However, there are challenges related to bovine tuberculosis in diagnostic methods because of low specificity and sensitivity. Most they rely on tuberculin tests, and it's low specificity, and also time-consuming, like for culture, and complicated procedures, and also requirement of expensive laboratory equipment, and also standardized laboratories. And these limit the use of these molecular or diagnostic tools in resource-limited areas, such as in Africa. For the pathogen in humans, Mycobacterium bovis is naturally resistant to pyrazinamide, a baseline TB drug that shortens the TB treatment. And also the presentation of zoonotic TB is quite similar to that of TB caused by Mycobacterium tuberculosis, and this results in misdiagnosis. Bovine tuberculosis and other NTDs affect millions of people, mostly in developing countries. And one main problem concerning the control of NTDs is diagnosis-based, because most affected areas, as I said, these are limited resources areas, they are far from standard laboratories, and there are challenges with current diagnostic methods, as I said earlier. So we embarked on a study in order to explore the best alternative on how we can find the best tool that could use simple procedures, use of low equipment, rapid testing, and can easily be integrated into resource-limited settings. And hence, we opted for LAMP assay. LAMP stands for loop-mediated isothermal amplification assay. It is a single tube technique for DNA amplification, and that was reported by Natoni and others. The technique utilizes standard displacement properties of the DNA polymerase. When you compare LAMP to PCR, you find that LAMP uses isothermal reaction, constant temperature, no use of equipment, expensive equipment such as thermocyclers, simple procedures and it's rapid. So looking at these advantages, we thought LAMP would be a better deal in order to detect Mycobacterium tuberculosis, Mycobacterium bovis larvae. In our previous study, we developed LAMP assay for specific detection of Mycobacterium bovis. We utilized the region of difference RD4 at 12.7 kb locus that is deleted in Mycobacterium bovis but present in other Mycobacterium tuberculosis species. So the history of Mycobacterium tuberculosis species is that they are 99.9% similar, but they evolved through from a common ancestor through deletion and insertion sequences. And one of them is the RD4 that is deleted entirely in Mycobacterium bovis and present in other species of MTBC. So we developed primers around that region that encompasses or that flanked the deletion part of RD4 in Mycobacterium bovis. These were our methodologies, the search primer design, and we went on until the confirmation of LAMP products. We found out that after testing around, designing and testing around 40 primer sets, a primer set with a deletion at 3' region of F1 was selected because it was high specificity and also sensitivity for the detection of Mycobacterium bovis. We tested the specificity of this LAMP using 149 isolates, and of which 65 were Mycobacterium bovis, and the established LAMP assay detected all the 65 as positive with cross reactivity on other isolates or from negative controls. We checked the sensitivity of this LAMP, and the sensitivity was 50 femtograms, which is equivalent to 10 bacterial genomes. And in comparison to multiplex LAMP, our LAMP assay was quite sensitive. We confirmed the LAMP products using enzymatic digestion and also in silico prediction. And this LAMP assay that we have developed proved variable in high specificity for the detecting of Mycobacterium bovis, also a proof of concept for the use of RD4 as a molecular marker. It has got a superior limit of detection and cheaper approach compared to other diagnostic methods. We think it's about $1 to $2 and also uses a low-cost equipment. However, we have a limitation with wet LAMP because we still need cold chain maintenance of, and storage of reagents such as the enzymes. So our next step that we did was to develop a dry LAMP assay in order to improve the wet LAMP that we already developed. So this one, we had an objective to evaluate it using food samples and also to estimate the current prevalence of bovine tuberculosis in Malawi. So in short, we optimized the wet LAMP and did other reaction testing, and this was done in Japan, and later we transported the LAMP, the dry LAMP kits to Malawi. In Malawi, we collected samples from abattoirs, three abattoirs. These are regional abattoirs, and these were the processes. One more interesting thing is when we are doing the sampling, and processing, we divided some samples that we captured and some samples we just did boiling without capturing. So we tested both. What if we can just take samples from cattle and extract DNA and test it this one? So these results of this procedure is still going on as we are preparing for manuscript. And yes, I didn't share the results, but the kits were developed in Japan and transported to Malawi and kept for 5 months and had a better sensitivity and specificity. We were able to detect M bovis from DNA extracted directly from samples without culturing. And we also utilized this tool to determine apparent prevalence in Malawi. of bovine tuberculosis for so long. I would like to acknowledge the collaborators from the University of Zambia, here at the University of Hokkaido and in Malawi, and this way it was funded by Hokkaido University. Thank you so much.